So those people who got healed by the false healing, they will say, well, I practiced New Start, but then I get sick again and sick again, so okay, forget about New Start. And then they drink and eat bad things, and they finally die. So that's what Satan is doing. So in this world, this false healing is all around. You know, actually, Oriental medicine, you know, their acupuncture, a lot of people got healed because of that treatment. You know, belief is very important in our human life. Why? Because according to what you believe or who you believe, you know, things happen.
Law of attraction.
Have you ever heard of the law of attraction? Or Hicks law? Have you ever heard this? They have about the same scientific background that I have told you so far. They say there is some kind of spiritual power, like the attract something, like a law of attraction or the Hicks law. That Hicks found this law, so they call this Hicks law or the law of attraction. It's a kind of new age as well. So to accomplish something, if you want to accomplish something, recite some kind of word, spell, and then visualize that. That's what it is. Let's say, I want to get promoted. You keep saying it. And then you visualize what you're going to be. And then, all of a sudden, now you're promoted. Oprah Winfrey is teaching this kind of law of attraction. A lot of people got rich because of this kind of practice. So a lot of people gather into this kind of movement. The book called Secret is about this. You know, our mind is very evil. So instead of praying to close to God, but then you pray for the secular things. Why? Because there is no Jesus Christ in those people. This morning I went hiking and I prayed and I prayed. I prayed to God. I talked to God. God, I don't want to get upset with wife. Please help me. I don't really get upset with people easily. I am gentle with people usually, but I don't really practice this gentleness to my wife. I am not a good husband. So I was praying to God. God, please help me. I want to be a good husband. Please. Please help me. I don't want to get upset with my wife. Please help. Help me. You know, the transforming character is very important. Even though we know this, theologically, I can understand. I could understand in my head, but it's very difficult for me to practice. I need to be changed. I need to go forward looking at Jesus Christ. However, in this world, they say, seek and you will receive. They use this Bible verse in a worldly way, and then Satan works in a very strange way. And there are so many people who have this wonderful testimonies. If you read that book called Secret, you will see a lot of people's testimonies. And they say, well, so-and-so-and-so process, I become a millionaire. And then when people read this, when the world reads this, they are so excited. And they say, there is power, spiritual power that you haven't thought about. That power, that spiritual power is there for you. If you receive that power, you can do anything. That's how they teach people. So people believe. And they're okay. And then things started to happen. Especially in healing field, a lot of people practice this false healing, using this kind of false power. There are so many kinds of healing arts in Korea. In America, not so many, but in Korea, we have, yes, a lot. And we are very used to those things. What is that? One of that is pricking your fingers. When I was 7 or 8, you know, I have a stomachache, and my grandmother said, oh, come here, let me prick your finger. You know, she... she pressed down the blood. Well, there, you know, you have this venous blood on the surface. And then this arterial blood comes out of the heart and goes through the body. And they receive this carbon dioxide and go back to the heart, and it gives back forward to the body, so it circulates in your body. So arterial blood and then venous blood, they circulates to receive oxygen, and then they receive carbon dioxide, and then they flow, circulates in our body. But actually we call this arterial blood and venous blood, but actually they are the same blood. Arterial blood becomes the venous blood, and the venous blood becomes the arterial blood because they circulates. So if there is something bad in our bloodstream, they're all melted all around our body. There is not a place where those bad blood stays. There is good blood and there is bad blood. It's not like that. The blood is one in a one stream. So let's say if you have something bad, then they're all melted in every blood and every part of your body. They're all melted in the bloodstream. So now you gather this venous blood. Now if you gather your venous blood, it means the venous blood has a lot of carbon dioxide. So the color of the venous blood gets darker. Now the blood which received the oxygen from the heart, they are very red. The color is very red because they have good oxygen melted in them. That arterial blood goes to the cells, and then they receive the carbon dioxide from the cell, and they go back to the heart. Now, venous blood, they have a lot of carbon dioxide, and so the color is darker than the arterial blood. But essentially, they are one blood. After circulation, then the arterial blood becomes the venous blood, and venous blood becomes the arterial blood. And then what my grandmother did, she gathered my venous blood, and she used the thread holding my finger, the tip of my finger. If you press your fingertip, then you know you have this darker color. It's because they don't have enough oxygen. If you hold your fingertip, then those blood, they are stuck there. And because the cell is using that blood only, so the blood has a lot of carbon dioxide, and so the color is darker and darker, so like black, darker, darker. So if you prick that finger, then the color is black. And then people call this blood bad blood. Now your bad blood is out, so you will get better. Well, you were sick is because you had this bad blood. And when Granny says that to me, told me, I believed. No, when you believe, you have this alpha wave and you feel better after that. Now you tell me that there is a person who got fainted, and then so you prick their 10 fingers, and then that person got conscious again, and then you believe that that person came back to consciousness because you pricked their 10 fingers. Do you believe in that? It's not like that. Now, by the time if you prick 10 fingers, it's about time for that fainted person to get back to conscious. And then the fainted person, when the person felt, you know, those pricking feelings, they still also get back to conscious. You know, when someone is fainted, you sometimes slap their, you know, cheeks, and then they come to conscious. In America, you don't prick their fingers, but they still come back to conscious. So it's not about the pricking fingers. In Korea, we have this therapy. They drink their urine to get better. This is called urine therapy. Well, actually, they have very strong theory, actually. Now, I was having my New Start seminar in Suwon, and the person gave me his name card. He was the professor of a certain university. And this professor told me that 6 months later, we're going to have a world urine therapy or something. Please, would you come to our seminar and have the opening remarks? And he asked, so I said, why do you ask me to do the opening remark? And he said, well, you are practicing alternative medicine. So I said, well, no. You know, what we are doing here is not alternative medicine. We talk about the life energy and the life energy in the Word of God. And we're talking about this Word of God. We give this word of God to the patients. We're talking about this. We're not talking about medicinal, herbal medicine, or the certain food, and so forth. We're not talking about use something to get people better. We don't teach this here. New Star is not alternative medicine. New Star is the word medicine. We don't use any kind of treatments to get people better, healed. Those people who come to our New Start Center, they have been to all around alternative medicinal agencies or the hospitals. Those people, they carry those, we called it idolatry baggage, I call this. They bring all those kind of food or the medicine with them when they come to our New Start seminar. But I teach them the life is in the Word of God. As they listen to the lectures, they believe that, oh, so the life is in the Word of God, not in those kind of things. So they throw them away. Those who don't throw those things away, they don't get better. Let's go back to this neuron therapy. Just because you drink your urine, you don't get better. But somehow, there are some people who get better because of those drinking their own urine. This is really false urine. I mean, false therapy, false healing. According to what they say there are many good things in the urine. Yeah, I can agree with that. In our bloodstream, yes, of course, there are many good things. And then urine, blood get filtered in the kidney. So in the urine, there might be some good things in the urine. And those good things, they are not needed in the body anymore, so they got filtered. So the kidney. Now let's say vitamin C is very good for your health. So people take too much of vitamin C pills, and then vitamin C, because if it's too much in your blood, then it is in your urine. So remember, drinking urine is not going to be a help. Pricking your fingers won't get you healed. You know, in Oriental medicine, there's cupping, right? Cupping? That's also a way of pricking your fingers. Developed way of pricking fingers. When you do the cuppings, they have this vacuum power. So before the cupping, they prick some of the parts of the skin of your body, and then that blood got sucked by the cupping. You know, if your blood is healthy, when it is out of the body, they become clotted. When the blood comes out of the blood vessel, God turns this one gene to clot the blood, so blood clots. If the blood doesn't clot, then it's a bad blood. Anyways, those cupping therapists, they say, see, the bad blood clots. But that's not right. So when the blood clots, when it is out of the outside of the body, it is the normal blood. If the blood doesn't clot when the therapist practices the cupping, that it's a very big problem because the blood will constantly flow out of the body. So those oriental medicine, those cupping, they say if the bad blood comes out of the body, then you will get better. When the patients believe in that, their genes can be healed by that belief. People use this kind of oriental medicine, cupping or the pricking fingers. They do this just to gather people. Just to gather people in the church. Even the churches, our churches practice this cupping or the pricking fingers in the church. You know, when I was young, my grandmother, back to that story, my grandmother asked me to have this pricking fingers, but I didn't want her to prick my finger because I couldn't understand even though I was young. And maybe that's how I am now, or what I am. When Paul's boat was wrecked, Paul went to this island. And the poisonous serpent came out and bit Paul, but Paul didn't die. So those natives were converted because of this kind of miraculous work. Well, in that sense, yeah, God can use this kind of way of miracles. Now go back to this cupping story. Now you have this cupping, and then your blood pressure went down, and then patients, the hypertension patient, he's very happy. But then he was very upset somehow, so he came back to the hospital to have this cupping, and then he just got this cupping. But then a month later, he has hypertension again, so he came back. Now the cupping and coming back, and several months later, you know, let's say a pastor says, well, let's study the Bible. And so this patient, several months later, he got baptized. While he was studying the Bible, the love of Jesus came into this hypertension patient. Now, the Word of God, the love of God, healed this person. So after he got baptized, he didn't have this hypertension because the Word of God healed him. So after baptism, he didn't have to receive this cupping therapy. Then you have to explain that the Word of God has this natural healing power. You have to notice this. Okay, it's not about the copying. It's about the Word of God. And there's the movement, New Start. If you practice this, you'll get better. It's not just about the hypertension, but maybe you might get obesity or diabetes and other diseases. But if you practice the law of God, if you practice New Start, you will get healed and you will be happy. So use this New Start as like a bait. When you fish,
직접적으로 그렇게 얘기하면 맞을 수 있는 얘기죠.
Yes, if you say this is like a satanic ways of doing whatever, but you know, we don't want to make money doing this. Our original purpose is to save souls. That's our purpose. So those people who don't understand the Word of God or who don't understand this level of New Start philosophy, then you can start out with this kind of easy way to level with them. You know, people took those blind and the deaf to Jesus. Now, those deaf and the blind, they couldn't hear of Jesus, they couldn't see Jesus, so they didn't know about Jesus. But people said, well, you should go to Jesus. So they took them to Jesus, even though they didn't know about Jesus. Now the patients, the deaf and the blind, they don't know about Jesus. So Jesus, do you know what Jesus did to them? So Jesus took them where there is nobody. Took those patients where there is nobody. So God put his fingers to their ears, and then Evara, open, and then open your, stick out your tongue. So he spit his saliva, and then touch his tongue, and then his tongue got melted, so he could speak. Well, God practiced these things where there is nobody. Why? It's because the deaf and the blind, they don't know, they are not educated, and they haven't heard about Jesus. They are, let's say, uneducated. So God leveled with them. Well, because these people believe that, oh, because Jesus put his fingers in my ears, and because Jesus touched my tongue, I could speak. Because Jesus did something on my eyes so I could see. So because they believe in these kind of things or performances, Jesus treated them in their level. Jesus goes down where they're at. But Jesus, he doesn't want people to look at this, because people would think then Jesus is a magician. Whatever he touches, whatever he does, then you know they're healed. That's why Jesus took them where there is nobody. Well, actually, after that, Jesus always said, don't talk about this to people, but go to the priest and study the Bible. But then people don't listen to Jesus. And that's why people just gather to Jesus and touch me and do this and do that for me. So Jesus couldn't do his work. His gospel medical ministry turned into medical ministry. Well, in Korea, we say gospel ministry and then medical ministry. They're separated. But Ellen G. White says gospel medical ministry. We get people healed through the Word of God. But we think, Sang Lee comes to our church, do the medical ministry, then we pastors will do the gospel ministry. That's the way we're thinking in Korea. According to the level of people, according to the spiritual level of people or the knowledge level of people, Jesus met them. And I think that is mercy and grace. Well, me is the same way. Whenever when I go to a place where there are people are uneducated, then you know I prick their fingers, they you know acupuncture whatever, I do something so that they have trust in this lecture, and then I lead them to the true path. But you shouldn't say that that should be combined with the Word of God. I mean, when I say that is like the copying or acupuncture or the pricking their fingers or the charcoal or those kind of things. That can be combined with the Word of God, but we shouldn't say that is the true way of ministry. It is just meeting people where they're at. Even pastors, it's very difficult for them to understand the Word of God heals people. That's why there are so many remedies like the charcoal or a certain type of juice. Somehow people get better is because, you know, Seventh-day Adventists, they're so good, they're so nice, good people, and they really take good care of those patients. Those patients got better is because of the true or the caring heart, but people believe that, oh, because of the charcoal, the person got better. So misunderstanding is all around. So you have to understand really well about this theobiology. And Sister White wrote her writings rationally. There are some people say if you take charcoal, your diabetes will get better, your hypertension will disappear. They say this, but that is nonsense. Now, we're talking about healing here, but those charcoal or other medicinal herbs or hydro, remember hydro? Therapy, that's the therapy, not the healing. We relieve the symptoms. We don't call hydro healing, we say hydrotherapy. We call it massage therapy, not the healing. Healing only comes from the Word of God and the life energy. You have to be sure, and you have to sure about this truth. Centurion said, "Say the word, Master." You should be sure about this truth. Every time, every day, even though I teach this, it's very difficult to implant this idea in you. You know, charcoal, in case of charcoal, when you have indigestion, you take charcoal. Well, me, before I sometimes took it, but these days I don't have to even because I digest so well. Right after I got baptized, I took a lot of charcoal. Yeah, charcoal works. If you have bee stung or the ants bite, yeah, of course it absorbs those poison. When you use this charcoal patch on your skin, and when you cannot digest well, yeah, if you take medicine, yes, it works. But charcoal doesn't restore your genes. But the love or the care or the worries of a certain deaconess, you know. If this deaconess takes good care of this certain patient, well, they get better, not because of the charcoal, but because of this deaconess's care and love. We should remember this spiritual energy. When we talk about healing, we should understand the spiritual level of healing. This is very delicate. Theologically, you need to establish this idea so that you are not going to be fooled later. So if you say, whatever you do something in a specific way, then you get better. Then, you know, you are actually degrading God's level of healing. So you should remember the Word of God, only the Word of God is the life energy. You need to keep this. You need to preserve this truth. And we are responsible for this. The remnant church leaders need to keep this truth because the world doesn't know about the truth. That's why this New Start message is given to this remnant church by the prophet, and so that we can experience this. We are practicing this New Start not to make people get healed, not that only purpose, but we need to make sure, we need to practice this to make people understand that the Word of God heals them. We need to build this kind of people in this world so that they preach also to the world. You know, remember I told you I had various forms of sickness, like about 15 or 12 or 15. Even though I was a doctor, I couldn't take care of myself. I could just manage. Those therapies cannot get me healed. But God led me to Seventh-day Adventist Church, and He also gave me this New Start message. And He enlightened me so that I could understand the Word of God better. And now, I am absolutely fine. You know, so that I can testify my experience to you now, because I have this experience in the Word of God. I've been practicing this New Start since 1982. Now, I've been practicing New Start for 27 years. And recently, I came to this conclusion, okay, health is character. Health is the character. You got this New Start message, and you got the Bible study, and you become more religious, and you get to know God more, and then you keep building the relationship with God. And so your character is changing day by day, and those people, those who are practicing this process, who have been in this process, they are very happy. You know, I met a lot of CEOs, like one of the CEOs in Samsung. He realized this truth about God, and they got baptized even. You know, a lot of educated people, a lot of CEOs, and a lot of high socially positioned people, they're baptized because they knew or they accepted the character of God. and they show the character of God in them. Those who have good relationship with God and those who believe in the true character of God, their lifestyle doesn't change. Since it was changed, it doesn't change. You know, my wife's brother-in-law, he just loved all the junky things before. But for him now, best restaurant is New Start Restaurant. His taste has changed.
They're talking about which New Start restaurant is better.
사실 어땠냐면 제가 가끔 이제 집을 이제 방문하잖아요. 가끔 이제
Sometimes I visit his house.
잠자리가 없어서 이제 동선의 집에 가서 이제 하룻밤 신세를 지낸다. 그러면 저녁 먹으러 가자. 이렇게 되면은 내가 가서 저녁 먹으러 가는 게 제일 싫은 거야.
You know, sometimes I visited his house before he got baptized, before he was converted. I sometimes visited his house to stay overnight because I had no place to sleep while I was having this New Star seminar in his area. And then he hated me going to dinner with him because the food I liked, he didn't like. So we had very awkward relationship before, but now he asked me all the Bible questions, and then we always talk about this Bible and God, and it's so wonderful to have this heavenly relationship with my brother-in-law. Now, expectation and dopamine release. Very famous science magazine, the title Expectation and Dopamine Release. Now, dopamine, it gives you this exotic feeling. Now, let's, for example, you're in the Las Vegas and you had this jackpot and you got this all the money down and then you hear this ding 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 sound. And then those gambling plays, people got all excited for you. That's when the dopamine is released. So when the dopamine is released, you feel that kind of excitement. You know, Jisung Park, he's crazy about soccer. He's a soccer player in Manchester United. When he had nice pass and when he made a goal, he gets very excited. And then, you know, when they finally make the goal or when they finally make the team win, they become very excited. For me, now let's say this patient needs Jesus, because if he doesn't accept Jesus, he will die in 3 months or something. Then I sit, you know, with him and I have to persuade, I have to tell him about Jesus and why you need Jesus. So I talk to him, I talk to my patients about genes and Jesus and so forth. And after a while he said, Dr. Lee, I know. I need to go to Jesus to live. Thank you so much, Dr. Lee. And he cries. And when I see that scene, I feel like, yes, this is it. So we pray, we thank God. And, you know, the patient left. And in my room, I get so excited because he accepted Jesus Christ in his life. And I get so excited. For me, that's when the dopamine is released. Yeah, when you have that experience in your life, yeah, your religious life is so wonderful.
So 저는 참 여러분들처럼 이 목회하면 꼴통 장로도 있고 꼴통 집사도 있고 해서 예를 들면 그런 사람이 없고
You know, me, I'm not a pastor at the church, but maybe you guys in the church, there are some people trouble you, like the elders or deaconesses, or some people trouble you, but me, I have no that kind of people. So I get excited a lot because of these, you know, patients who accepted Jesus. You know, I go to New York, northern area, there's a New Start church, and every year they have this New Start. Every year. To have this, to hold this seminar, all the church members, they have same vacation. So they rent a hotel and they serve their neighbors and the patients around them. And they get so excited when those patients get healed. So deaconesses and deacons, they're all one. Elders, they're all one. And so the church members, they donate their money to open or hold this New Start movement because they're so happy when they see people get healed. If you once tasted this beauty of life, you know, they get into this. They can't get out of this. We should be addicted to this New Start. We need to be addicted to life. In that kind of level, when I say addict, that's the level when I use this term. When the dopamine is released, you get very excited, but not only that, but you become very romantic. You know, the feelings of that romantic, that's also from this dopamine. You become very flexible. You don't get upset easily when the dopamine is released. So when the dopamine is released, you become a very gentle person. So when you are flexible, you can dance like in this way. You become very smooth and flexible. Now, Parkinson's disease, by the way, dopamine is not released in that people. So when the dopamine is not released, you become very frigid and stiff. Not just about your body, but about your mind as well. So you become very upset easily, and you become angry as well. And then your body, before you could write really well, or paint, or draw, but then when you get Parkinson's disease, you can't even you can have this feeble walk, and biologically doesn't work as well. Why? Because dopamine is not released. And then you give them this, let's say, flour, you know, white powder, flour. And they say, well, this is the medicine for you. And if you take this medicine, dopamine is going to be released very well. You know, let's say you lied, but then if the patient believed, when they believe, they have expectation. So that's what the title is about, expectation and dopamine release. Mechanism of the placebo effect in Parkinson's disease. You know what the placebo means, right? Even though you receive not the real, you don't receive the real medicine, but then you will have the impact because you believe it. Well, the result is this. Here, we provide in vivo evidence.
생체 내 이름합니다. 여기 in vitro라고 하는 것은 실험관 안에서 이런 얘기고 이거는 생체.
Here, vivo means in your body, biologically inside of your body. So we provide in vivo evidence.
를 지금 여러분에게 드리고 있다. 어떤 건데?
For substantial
release of
endogenous dopamine in the
Parkinson's 환자에서 이러한 상당량의 도파민이 생산되는
stratum of Parkinson's disease patients in response to placebo.
In response to 여기 보면 in response to placebo. 위약에 대하여. 그래서 실제로 믿는 환자들은
So those who believe, their genes are turned on, and then dopamine was released.
근데 이제 그거는 의사가 밀가루 알약을 주면서
And the doctor, when the doctor gave him,
어떻게?
When the doctor gives the patients those, you know, fake medicine, the doctor should be good at lying. The doctor should be a trustworthy doctor. Let's say a doctor came in, and the doctor was busy doing his own thing, is talking on the phone, and he was talking on the phone, hey, all right, do something and do this, and okay, let's go this place, and let's meet at this time. Okay, I see. We'll play card games as well. And then the patient was sitting in front of the doctor, and then the patient felt like, oh, this person is not a trustworthy doctor. And then the doctor gave him this fake medicine and says, well, this is good for Parkinson's disease. Do you know what happened to this patient? Dopamine was not released.
한 이유가 뭐냐면
Well, me, I successfully practiced my clinic is because I think
미국 사람들 인종차별을 그렇게 우리처럼 심하게
Well, Americans, they don't have You know, for Koreans, we think we are the best because we have this name for certain people, okay? We think we are the best people or race in the world. However, Americans, they don't have that kind of serious racism. If you present yourself in a very serious way, in a trustworthy way, then the effect or the result is a lot better. Even though they use the same medicine, the result is a lot better. That is also the placebo effect. We need to have this placebo effect, but not the material things, but we should let the patients believe in the Word of God. Parkinson's disease, yes, it can be healed. When the word of God gets into this person. Well, there are some people, even though they participate in New Star movement, but there are some patients who don't get well. It means they don't accept the power of the Word of God. Well, they only look up to me. But then I only say that, you know, look up to Jesus. But then those patients say, well, it's very difficult for them. And then they're confused. They sometimes come to the New Start Seminar once or twice a year, but then they can't make it because they don't go to the core. Of life. However, there's a patient. He used to live in Incheon.
이 집안이 어떤 집안이냐면 충청도 양반이야. 그래서 뭐 마다들 맏며느리로 들어와가지고 뭐 유세차.
Now this lady got married to this one of the Chungcheong man in Korea, and that area is very conservative. And she was the first son's daughter. So here in Korea, traditionally, they have a lot of stress, and because they have this Confucianism, they follow the rules of the Confucianism. So her life got really stressed all the time, and she was always intense. So she finally got this Parkinson's disease. So she goes to the hospital and gets this medicine, but you know, those medicine gets her side effects only. So she finally get to the New Start Center. Now this lady, she couldn't even get off the bus. So one of the staff from New Start, you know, they gave her a piggyback, and she had to sit in the wheelchair because she couldn't walk. Whenever she goes to the bathroom, you know, her husband, you know, took her to the bathroom. So she couldn't walk. She was very stiff. Somehow her husband realized the truth of the Word of God. Remember I told you about the farmer, that guy? This is the same case. The husband realized the Word of God and the love of God. He said, as I listen to you, we practice Confucianism, but then I didn't know who God is. You know, at the time I was having this New Start seminar in America, Weimar, for 3 weeks. So only the rich people came from Korea. You know, Kongts, the word of Kongts, it's all about the Bible, but the level Bible is a lot higher than Kongts, which is the leader of the Confucianism. So this husband, however, as he listens to the word of God, he decided to accept the Christ. You know, Confucianism, women are supposed to respect their husbands, so they have to serve their husbands in that way. But this husband started to understand the character of God and the love of God, and he knew that Jesus came to this earth not to be served, but to serve. So he realized the truth. So this husband says that, honey, we are not going to have this ritual service anymore. So this woman was touched by what the husband said. And then this husband helped the wife a lot, carefully and gently. So this wife came to the Bible seminar, and then she also started to study the Bible. Now this woman started to walk slowly, gradually. It's not the power of brown rice or the vegetarian diet, but it's the power of the Word of God. So last 1 week, she could walk without the staff. And that couple came back to Korea. 1 year later, I came to Korea for a short time. We had a seminar in Yangpyeong area in Korea, because those New Start people, they gathered together once a year, and then they had this 3 nights, 4 days seminar, short seminar in Korea, because they wanted to get together and talk about their lives. They wanted to share it together. Anyway, this woman came. She came with the staff. So I thought, oh, maybe she got worse, because she walked, you know, that she had this feeble walk with the staff. You know, in that place, actually, that seminar, people testify their testimonies like, you know, I did this and I got better, and I did that, I got better. You know, that's why we get together. But this lady, she came with her staff, and so I thought, she didn't get well, and what is she going to testify? She didn't get well. Now, she came with a feeble walk, and she held up this staff, and she threw this staff away, and then she started to dance. Lala, and she started to dance on the stage. She just pretended that she didn't get better because she wanted to surprise me. So that was a nice surprise. And she started to give us the testimony. It was so beautiful. Her husband persuaded all the relatives, but somehow, you know, of course, they criticized the couple, but this husband helped her wife a lot, and both of them got baptized. And they have this one nice big building in their hometown. You know, first and the second and third floor, there's offices and everything. And the fifth floor, they lived on the fifth floor. Every day, they went upstairs and they sang Smile Song. They sang together and they, you know, sang Smile Song. Well, actually, we need to, you know, sing that Smile Song as well here. Anyway, this woman got freed from Parkinson's disease. Yeah, when the spiritual level of experience is with you, there's no incurable disease. But then people somehow don't choose that way. So you know, leaders and teachers should be very sure about this theobiology and the power of the Holy Spirit. Councils on Health, page 31. The power of love is life-giving energy. And also, page 30, while he did not give countenance to drug medication, he sanctioned the use of simple and natural remedies. Yeah, remedies are not the healers, but God allowed man to use these natural remedies. Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 33. There's a word, inward parts. I looked it up in the Hebrews, Old Testament 7:1-35. Now, Jeremiah 31, verse 33, in English, it says, inward parts.
Inward parts. Parts라는 말 무슨 말이에요? 부속품이란 말이죠, 부속. 우리 몸 속에
There are parts inside of our body. I think that is the genes. In Hebrew's translation, it says, number one, in a physical sense. In a physical sense, as the seat of thought and emotion. And I think that is gene. That is our genes. You know, our emotion, like endorphins produced, and our thoughts, you know, that changes. I think Hebrews people, they have this in their language. And another meaning, as the faculty of thought and emotion. That's what the Hebrews translation says. Here, Councils on Health, page 28, the blessing of God is a healing power. That's what it says. The blessing of God is a healing power. So that's the energy which heals. So when God says, bless the Sabbath, means the blessings, that energy is in Sabbath. That should be the identity of Sabbath. Then we know that there is life in Sabbath, and we can testify this. Psalms 133, verse 3, it says, blessings is a life. Blessing is a life. That's what it says in Psalms 133, verse 3. Again, page 30, Counsels on Health, page 30. He imparted his life to the sick, the afflicted, those who possessed of demons. He turned away none who came to receive his healing power. He knew that those who petitioned him for help had brought disease upon themselves, yet he did not refuse to heal them. The gospel still possesses the same power. And why should we not today witness the same results? Counsels on Health, page 30.
The gospel still possesses. 그러므로 이 복음이란 것은 아직도 그것을 소유하고 있다. 무엇을 소유하고 있나? 꼭 같은 파워. 그 예수님 당시에 꼭 같은 그러한 치유력을 가지고 있다. 그래서 why should we not today witness the same?
The gospel has the same power that Jesus had in his time, the healing power. Again, Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 33, in English version, it says, write in my laws in their hearts. In English version, this is hearts. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 3, or Proverbs chapter 7, verse 3, it says heart there. And also in Psalms chapter 51, Psalms 51, verse 10, also says heart there. So write my laws in their hearts, and then hearts and hearts and hearts on those Bible verses. In Hebrews translation, that is the mind, knowledge, the thinking, reflection, the memory, inclination, and resolution, determination of will, the conscience. That's how it is translated in Hebrews. This is the New Testimony, Galatians chapter 4, verse 6. Again, hearts. In Greek, cardia means denotes the seat and center of all physical and spiritual life. Interesting, it says physical and spiritual life. So hearts in Hebrew, the Greek says universally, cardia denotes the seat and the center of all physical and spiritual life. So I think the Bible has the meaning of the genes, even though because they didn't know the word genes, they didn't use it, but I'm sure the Bible knows the meaning of the genes. We read this Medical Ministry, chapter 14, Medical Ministry, page 14. God's servants today could not work by means of miracles because superior works of healing, claiming to be divine, will be wrought by Satan. For this reason, the Lord has marked out a way in which His people are to carry forward a work of physical healing combined with the teaching of the Word. God gave us this work of physical thing with the Word of God. The last readings here, Counsels on Diet, page 301. There are many ways of practicing the healing art. But there is only one way that heaven approves. God's remedies are the simple agencies of nature that will not tax or debilitate the system through their powerful properties. Pure air and water, cleanliness, a proper diet, purity of life, and a firm trust in God are remedies for the want of which thousands are dying. Counsels on Diet, page 301. So when we have this infrastructure, the Word of God will work better. When we are tested, God gives us a way to escape. So the New Start message is just the way to escape. It's not the healer itself. So we reviewed spiritual prophecies so far today. And from tomorrow, we'll get into specifically in a disease, more disease part, biologically. Let us pray. Loving our Lord, this world doesn't understand what true life is. They want to solve this problem by their own hands, use the material things. That was the Satan's way. But God, you chose this remnant church and you gave us this message. Father, we want to depend on this only one way. We want to go to the true healer, Jesus Christ. Father, help us to understand clearly this theobiology. So please pour your Holy Spirit in our hearts so that we can understand your will and your mission. Father, we want to be out of this Kabbalistic or dualistic, spiritualistic way of understanding. Father, help us to be the true believer of God. Please, may the Spirit lead our steps. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.